Hello, welcome to the fourth lecture of this HYSYS training. I'm John White from geniusescreed, and today we are going to learn the following things. First and foremost, define a new component using hypotheticals. Hypotheticals are components that do not exist in HYSYS already, but we have an information or two about them, so we can try to simulate these components. We will also learn to operate a compressor in HYSYS to model a compressing process, and also determine the compressor efficiency and outlet temperature, just like we did in the pump. So the prerequisites are these. If you do not know how to do any of these, kindly refer to the first lecture in this particular series. Now here's the problem statement. Compressors are used to move gases. The compressor increases the pressure of the gas. We know that pumps increase lectures of liquid, but compressors are used for gases. Now a mixture of natural gas, that's methane, ethane, propane, butane, I-butane, N-butane, and C1 to NC6 and C7 plus, as in heavy bottom, at 100 degrees Celsius and 1 bar is fed into a compressor that has only 30% efficiency. The flow rate is 100 kilogram mole per hour, and its outlet pressure from the compressor is 5 bar. Using the Pegg-Robertson equation of state as a fluid package, determine the outlet temperature of the natural gas. So this is what we are going to do. We assess HYSYS, we install the stream, we add the unit operation, we connect compressor with streams, we specify the efficiency of the compressor. Then for the hypothetical component, we click on hypotheticals, we provide laboratory data, in this case the NBP. Boiling point is 110 degrees Celsius. We click on estimate. You see it when we start the simulation. Now these are the data, the mole fractions of each component. So let's go to HYSYS. So we click on new case. The component list, we have to add C1 to C6. So to do this, you can click on methane first, then hold your shift key, then arrow down till we reach hexane, which is NC6. Then when you get there, just click on add. It adds all of them. As you can see, it adds everything at the same. That's the seven. How many components do you have there? Three. That's 8 components. So we've added that. Remaining for us to add the C7 plus. So we click on hypothetical. Since HYSYS does not have it, we're not creating a batch of hypos, we're just creating a single one. So say new hypo here. Let's name it C7 plus. We have the normal boiling point to be 110 degrees Celsius. The more information you have, you can specify, but once you just specify a single one, it's where the normal boiling point, you can estimate the unknown. So click on estimate unknown, and it does this. Then click on the C7 plus, then add it to your component list. Comes here. So also come to fluid package. We are asked to use the Pegg-Robertson equation of state. So we click on Pegg-Robertson. Now finally we can leave this properties environment and move to the simulation environment. So another way, I told you we could create streams from the equipment themselves. So this is a compressor. You can double click on it to begin up. We can call this natural gas comp compressor. Okay, we are yet to save our work, so let's save it control S. Lecture 4. Then the inlet, let's call it inlet natural gas. The outlet natural gas. It creates the streams automatically. The energy stream SAQ1. Then we'll come to parameters here to specify the efficiency, which is 30. Just is 30%. So let's come to the worksheet here to provide information about the stream. First and foremost, let's go to composition. The inlet should be this 0.33 for methane. For ethane, we have 0.143. For propane, we have 0.101. For I-butane, we have 0.080. For N-butane, we have 0.098. For I-pentane, we have 0.059 and 0.069. For the N-hexane, we have 0.078. And for the C7 plus, we have 0.042. So that is that. We come to the conditions here. We're given that the temperature was 100 degrees Celsius at 1 bar. We're given the molar fluid to be 100 kilogram over half. So ceasing unknown DT, we know that the final pressure according to the problem statement is 5 bar. So we can say 5 bar here, and that is solved. We have to find the new temperature, which is 265.8 degrees Celsius. So that's that. So you can move up and down here, I think. This is the final simulation. Let's go back to our slide. The question is determine the outlet temperature, which we've done. Then the problem is, if the outlet temperature is 400 degrees Celsius, what is the compressor's efficiency? So let's go back to the simulation. Double click on the compressor, then the design, the parameter. We come here and delete. Then we'll come back to our worksheet and specify that temperature is 400 degrees Celsius. So it should work now. Okay, design. So the new efficiency is 14.946%. And that's all for today. I really hope you learned. Please do well to practice and kindly subscribe to this YouTube channel. You can also give us a thumbs up. Just in case you have any questions, you can drop them in the comment section, or you can contact us via our email. We'll respond to you as soon as we can. Also, if you need the software, you can specify by sending us an email. I'll try to upload it to my Google Drive. It's around 7 gigs, so you can download from them. Just send an email to notify us. Thank you very much.